The movie Dredd takes place in the futuristic megacity 1, a massive dystopian city-state replacing most of the US East Coast, and it's sporting a population of like 800 million people. That would be, in a word and a pun, dreadful.
I knew you'd say that.
But what's worse is the city experiences 12 serious crimes a minute, which, if multiplied by the number of minutes in a crime-ridden day, equals a staggering 17,280 crimes a day. As such, the city appears as a constant parade of violence, so the movies can justify the existence of judges, which are like regular police, only they can kill citizens whenever they want and not get in trouble for it. Just like real police!
Zinger!
Commentary!
Woo-hoo-hoo!
Now, 17,280 crimes sounds like a lot, but numbers like that mean jack squat on their own. You need something to compare them to. It's like a 17-inch dong would be impressive on Danny DeVito, but is embarrassing on King Kong. Mega City 1 is like King Kong here. 17,280 major crimes a day per 800 million people isn't great, but it's not really all that dystopian. Crime rates are calculated based on the total number of violent crimes per year. So 17,280 times 365 equals 6,307,200, which, yes, is a shockingly high amount of crimes on its own, but we need to divide it by the 800 million people living there and then multiply that by 100,000. Do all that, and Megacity's crime rate equals about 788.4 crimes per 100,000 residents. For comparison, there are cities in the real United States right now with similar or higher crime rates. The FBI reported that in 2019, there were 44 cities across America with a crime rate higher than 788.4. Detroit was the worst with 1,965 incidents per 100,000 residents. And no one's saying that Detroit is a picnic, but also nobody's saying that the crime rate is 2.5 times worse than Dredd and we should employ an army of futuristic murder cops to quell it. Well, I guess they do that in RoboCop, but that's a different thing.
Go f*** a refrigerator!
Like, yeah, the crime there is pretty bad, but it's not like regular people don't work there, raise families, and enjoy their regular non-dystopian lives. In fact, Megacity 1 has basically the crime rate of Columbia, South Carolina. And no one has proposed walling that city off from the rest of the country.
Yet.
But Dredd's not the only sci-fi movie that struggles with crime math. In Minority Report, they make a big deal out of having eliminated murder in the DC area. This is so successful and such a massive apparent improvement to citizens' way of life that the rest of the country is considering implementing the same crime-fighting system, which, to be clear, involves drugging tons of orphans until a few manage to not die, but do manage to get so coked out that they have nightmares about future murders and then wake up screaming so the cops can arrest the would-be killers and throw them in jail before they've committed any actual crimes. Now, stopping murder is probably a good thing, but for example, in DC in 2020, there were 124 homicides compared to 17,681 crimes total, none of which could be stopped by drugged up children because the only crime they report is murder. That means even the highest, most successfully balls-tripping kid would only effectively reduce crime by about 0.7%. Hell, even just violent crimes would drop by less than 5%, while things like sex abuse, robbery, assault, and other horrific crimes would continue unhindered. There have to be better uses for drugging children. Commentary? But wait, there's more! In Escape from New York, the US turns Manhattan into a prison island because crime in the US has risen by 400%. And again, yeah, a 400% rise in crime is bad, but it's not really all that dystopian because a similar thing already happened. In real life New York, between 1960 and 1993, just a few years after the movie takes place, rape alone increased by 400%, while murder went up 500% and robbery went up 1400%. No one is arguing that New York in the late 80s was a great place, but do we really think that they were this close to turning the entire city into a prison and just allowing cops to wander the streets executing people? Of course not. They only did the cop part.
Commentary.
But we're not done yet. Keanu Reeves' A Scanner Darkly claims that America lost the war on drugs because 20% of the population is addicted to a drug called Substance D. Sounds like a lot, right? Well, in 2017, 38% of Americans battled an illicit drug disorder. Not everything going on right now is great, but it's not like the whole country needs to sign off on an invasive high-tech surveillance system and a network of undercover officers and informants. They'll just do that anyway. Commentary, commentary. So the point is that even the most crime-infested dystopian worlds would actually be mostly fine to live in if it weren't for all the people trying to stop the crime. So the next time some movie, or some politician, tries to justify the creation of an army of violent robocops by quoting a bunch of crazy-sounding crime stats, maybe show them this video. It's the only thing between America descending into dystopia and, well, our current dystopian reality, I guess.